On this week's five things, wait a second, I mean the Xamarin Show, I have my friend David on talking to us about Xamarin Forms 3.5. Welcome back everyone to the Xamarin Show, Five Things Edition. I got my good friend David back on again to tell us about five things that he loves about Xamarin Forms 3.5. Five Things 3.5, how's it going, David?
It's going well, man. I like to keep things, you know, number focused. 3.5, five things. It's easy to remember.
That's awesome. Well, people don't know who you are. Give them a brief 30-second overview real quick.
Absolutely. So David Ortnow, Senior Program Manager for Mobile Dev Tools. And my area of focus is primarily the Xamarin Mobile SDKs. So that's iOS, Android, obviously, and then Forms especially, which we know that people love to use. And then we also work on components. So anything really related to that whole space.
Very cool. I'm really excited because I've already installed Xamarin Forms 3.5 into all my applications. I've been using a lot of the cool features. I figured I'd have you on. You're sort of the master of showing off all the really cool Xamarin Forms features. So do you just want to break it down for us, David?
Absolutely. Can I go ahead and share my screen?
Yeah, go for it. Let's give it a go. Let's see how Teams holds up.
So what we have here is the blog post that we published about Xamarin 3.5, Xamarin Forms 3.5. And I want to start with number four on the list because this is the thing that got me most excited. When I looked at this, how many community contributors we had to this release, it's just outstanding and so encouraging. Over the whole series of 3.0, I feel like we're seeing more and more contributions outside of Microsoft and the Xamarin Core team. So some new names here as well, which is always very exciting. Maybe the Hacktoberfest is what was bringing these people in. But it's just awesome to see these contributions. So wanted to highlight that first off the bat.
Yeah, it's very cool. I mean, I think a lot of times people forget that Xamarin and Xamarin Forms completely open source. You can contribute, you know, if you file a bug, but you can also fix a bug. I've done a few pull requests, so it's really cool to see it highlighted here.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, we're trying to make it easier for everybody. And this is one that was a contribution from Andre Nitescu. And this is what I'm showing you here is the Microsoft Conference Vision app. So if you look at my emulator and my phone over here on the side, you see my monkeys?
Yep.
So I've got my list view here on the first page, right? But then I've got another page of achievements. And this page has a fixed list of things. So I've got these badges, and you can see the only badge I actually achieved was the Xamarin badge, which, you know, is the most important badge on the whole
number one.
But you know, it's a fixed list of things here. So what you see in the code is what I had to originally do in Xamarin Forms 3.0 at build last year, which was to have a custom control that's a repeater view. And what this essentially is, it's a stack layout. Shane from our core engineering team, before he even joined Microsoft, had written this and published a gist. I imagine many people watching this are like, oh, I've written this before, you know? Yeah. It's just a layout that just iterates, and it's a repeater. Mm. So I was able to, with Xamarin Forms 3.5, take Andre's work and build that into, let's make sure I get the right project here. Boop, boop. All right. So this is that same page, it's the achievements view, and I was able to swap that out with just a flex layout, and here we have a bindable layout. And bindable layout is a simple way to just, you know, exactly what it sounds like, right? You've got a layout and you're going to bind some stuff to it. So I declare my item source, and then I declare my template. And it's as easy as that.
Very cool. So it's kind of like a list view in some way where you bind a list of data, but a list view has a built-in scroll view, things like that. But now you could use, I'm assuming, a grid, a stack layout, a flex out, any layout, and just here's all my items instead of manually adding them. Is that correct?
Exactly. Cool. And you know, I've been asked many times, okay, well, when do I use bindable layout? When do I use list view? And in preview right now, we have collection view. Name is TBD, so don't get too settled on the name. But people are asking, when do I use which one, right?
Yeah.
And with bindable layout, the thing to remember is that there is no recycling, there's no caching mechanisms. So it's not going to recycle events and be very performant for longer sets of data.
Got it.
But for something like what I've just demonstrated here with a list like this, I think there's maybe 30 things in here. I'm sure somebody probably could count that real quick. And it's not going to change other than some states. I don't need that to, you know, to be very virtualized.
Gotcha. That makes sense.
So this is a great case for that. It does support template selectors here in Bindable Layout. But again, this was a community contribution. We collaborated on the API spec and everything, and in fairly short order, we're able to get this thing in. So this has certainly been probably the hottest thing that everybody mentions in 3.5.
Very cool. I love it. It is one of my favorite features, and I love that it kind of gets rid of a lot of that boilerplate code that you used to have to write to do stuff like this.
Exactly, or that custom class in your library that you're always including in all your projects.
Yeah.
And I have another example here of doing exactly the same thing with a Flex layout, where I've got a list of contributors here. I could take this list of contributors. There's four of them, just four of them. I could take that and quickly refactor that out to a bindable list if I wanted to. Mm. So I'll show you on my screen here. It's just this list in the middle. Somebody changed their gravatars, so they're not showing up anymore. But my gravatar stays the same. I never change. I just gain weight. That's all that happens.
There you go.
All right, cool. So that's bindable layout, and I'll minimize that. And let's go look at a couple of other things. So I can get rid of my screen share here now. Stop mirroring. Go away. All right, so what I have here now is the Little Things Playground. Have you downloaded and used this at all?
I have. I love this project because you're always keeping it up to date with all kind of the latest and greatest features, which is really, really cool, and all the different versions. So it's very cool, and I'll put that in the show notes as well for people to take a look at.
Good. Well, I find it super helpful because it forces me to come look at these things, right, and test them out as we're doing pre-releases. So on the 3.5, which I've just recently updated this with the release, and I should note that we also have a service release already out for 3.5, so found some pretty high priority things we wanted to polish up. But this has the bindable layout in here as well. And if you didn't see this before, you can actually go quickly browse the XAML, which in portrait, it's kind of lame, but you go landscape and it's fairly readable, you know? I mean, that's a nice little thing that I wanted to highlight because it can be good for quick reference. But then we also have, in addition to the bindable layout, we have a couple of other little, what we call the F100s, right? These are the 100 little paper cuts that Xamarin Forms used to in the past, in the dark ages, inflict upon developers, right? Where you're thinking to yourself, why do I have to go write platform code to achieve this result? Forms should just do this.
Yep.
And so this is a great example, another contribution from community members, where essentially you have a table view and you want to change the color of the section header here, the vibrate, or the color of the selected state of the radio button.
Yeah.
You know, simple things, right? I mean, you shouldn't need to go do a bunch of work to make that happen.
Yeah, you got to just build it right in, I say. Give us all the options, so write less code. Just do it for me.
Exactly. So this is the code that's making that happen. Mm. So, and I get asked this question, actually, on occasion. Should I even use table view? So table view is good for doing something exactly like this. Or if you think of the settings screen on an iOS device where it has a very specific layout, and it's not one that's actually easily achieved in native code anymore. But our table view supports that. You give it an intent of settings, and you get that kind of formatting with sections and cells. Right here, you get your text color property, easy as that. And then on your switch cell, you get your on color property.
Very nice.
So, yeah. I mean, it's not blowing people's minds, but it does make your life so much easier, right?
Yeah, it's the little things that, you know, that's why it's called the little things, you know, little playground there, because sometimes it's just those little touches that you're like, oh, I want to go do that thing, and here it is, you know, for you, which is really nice.
Exactly. So, and I don't even really have to myself be, shouting too much about that stuff, because these are really ideas and suggestions coming from people that are using Xamarin Forms day in and day out for their daily work. I've had, probably a dozen or so calls in the past several days with customers, and they're always very appreciative to speak to me. But I got to tell you, it's an honor for me to speak to them so regularly, because it's when they tell me what they're struggling with that I have something very actionable that our team can do that is going to make a huge difference for them. So, and this is the fruit. This is the fruit of that.
Very cool.
So another thing on our five list, I don't know what number we're on here, but let's just keep rolling. There's five in here at least. Accessibility. So accessibility is something that we definitely prioritize and we want to make sure is easier and easier for developers in Xamarin. With Xamarin, because Forms Write lays on top of the native iOS and Android, you could always get to that stuff. You create a platform renderer or an effect, and you have quick access to do whatever you need to do. But again, if that's something that you're doing over and over and over again, you don't want to have to do that. Special cases, I hear from developers, totally fine. I'm creating something very custom. But just to handle a good screen reader, kind of being a good citizen, right, shouldn't have to do that. So toolbar items, back button and things like that have notoriously been difficult. Master detail page, the hamburger you get, wasn't being read properly by screen readers. So we've been able to clean some of those things up. It looks like I jacked up some of my formatting here, but automation properties, help text. Did I hit my keyboard?
Auto, there we go.
Watch out. They don't let me type, you know? They shouldn't let me type. Never know what's going on here. Somebody's going to comment in the show notes. What did you do?
Tomation properties. I don't know what those are. So automation properties, set some name, help text, and that really helps with the A11Y support, basically.
Exactly. Nice. So, yeah. And I will recommend, you know, go read the documentation on this stuff, because there are some rules in terms of what a screen reader will do and what priority will read things. Cool. So if you want to understand that better, and typically, you know, many teams will have a dedicated person for this task, because it's really to achieve certain levels of certification. You got to know some stuff.
Yeah.
So I really appreciate heavily the community input and, you know, people guiding me in understanding these things. All right.
Gotcha.
Let's see. What else do we have to feature in here? That was automation. That's bindable layout. That was text color. Let's go back to our blog post. Let's make sure. Did we miss anything? Where's my browser? Oh, that is the browser. Oh, Dave's flipping around in his browser again.
There we go. So we got toolbar accessibility, bindable layout. Right. Anything else we're missing from this one? We did have all the great things.
Oh, this is a great one. So this is another one of those seemingly simple things, right? But when you go to extend something like span, and you find that it's sealed or not public for you, it's super frustrating, because then you're like, I can't do what I need to be able to do. So as we hear about these things, and please let us know, we want to make sure we unseal them and make them public. You know, if that API is not going to change, if we're not changing names and in the midst of changing behaviors and things like that, then we absolutely should open those things up so that you have the ability to extend span, for example, and create your own hyperlink control or whatnot. So I think that that's a very popular one, and this is something that Michael Rumpler brought up, and Gerald Versluis, whose name I just did not pronounce properly, because I actually heard him. I watched a YouTube of him. What was he talking about? I don't even remember. But he was talking, and he pronounced his name, and I was like, oh, I totally botched his last name.
You'll get it right one day. Don't worry. With a name like Montemagno, you know, it takes a while sometimes.
Well, and my last name's Ort now, so I'm used to it over here as well. So
that's true.
All good. All right, so we did cover the community and Hacktoberfest contributions. I think the last thing on my five list was just general quality and polish for all the things that we're shipping. In particular, you know, we hear, hey, can we make Android performance faster for startup and for runtime? Can we make build times faster? Can we make the previewer work more consistently? Can we make our APK files smaller? So these are all things that are underway, and there's quite a bit of work that happens within the SDK teams to create better experiences in the tools as well. So when you're in Visual Studio, and I mentioned previewer as one example. So a lot of that work also has started to roll out in 3.5, and as features are going to light up in the IDEs, we'll be able to kind of showcase a bit more what we did on the SDK side to support those features. So
very cool.
Those are my five. Anything that you think I missed?
No, it's great. I love it. I love going through the release notes, going through those all those little features that the community put in. It's awesome. Yeah, thank you, David, for coming on, showing off all those five or maybe eight things that people can go get right now today. So go upgrade your projects and then email David immediately to tell him that it's awesome, or if something's wrong, he'll come and get on a chat with you anyway so we can solve your problems. Well, thanks, David, for coming on. I love it.
Thanks for having me, man.
Awesome. Well, we'll put all the links for documentation, release notes, and that great project that David showed off below. So thanks for tuning in. Make sure you subscribe either on YouTube or Channel 9. Ding that bell. Become a part of the notification squad so you get notified for every single new Xamarin Show. So until next time, I'm James. This has been The Xamarin Show.